Q106.7 weather.
Here's your KQNK forecast. High is around 71 today, under overcast skies, with a chance for storms, northeast winds 10 to 15 miles per hour. 55 tonight, chance of thunderstorms. High of 69 tomorrow, chance of thunderstorms. Low 70s Saturday, with a chance for storms. Turning much warmer Sunday, with highs in the low 80s, chance for storms continues. From the Weatherology Weather Center, I'm staff meteorologist Laura Lockwood. Currently, it's 67 degrees.
Kansas Information Network News, I'm Jen Austin. Emporia's enterprise funds, which include water, wastewater, and solid waste, are experiencing financial strain. Julio Flores has more.
City Manager Trey Conking announced plans to review water rates in October, as the fund is projected to have a negative balance by 2025. The aging infrastructure, with some pipes over 100 years old, is contributing to the financial pressure. The city has taken on $20 million in state loans for water infrastructure. The payment set to begin in 2026. Major expenses in the water fund include salaries, maintenance and repair, chemicals, water rights, electricity, and debt payments. I'm Julio Flores.
Voters in Rawlins County passed a school bond issue. Two-thirds voted in favor of the bond, and slightly more were in favor of a 1% sales tax to help fund that school bond. The old school was destroyed by arson in 2023. Plans are already in the works for a new building. The construction will begin this fall on the portion that will house grades 7 through 12. It'll be a K through 12 school when it's finished. This is Kansas Information Network News.
Have you lost CanCare? At healthcare.gov, you can find a low-cost, quality health plan.
Do plans cover doctor visits?
What about emergency care?
And prescriptions?
All covered and more. Plus, with the new law, 4 out of 5 customers can find a plan for $10 or less per month with financial help. Healthcare.gov is here for you. Enroll today for coverage starting the first of next month. Paid for by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Smokey the Bear.
Then you know why Smokey tells you when he sees you passing through. Remember, please be careful, it's the least that you can do.
It's what you desire, don't play with matches, don't play with fire.
After 80 years of learning his wildfire prevention tips, Smokey Bear lives within us all. Learn more at SmokeyBear.com. And remember,
only you can prevent wildfires.
Brought to you by the USDA Forest Service, your state forester, and the Ad Council.
Good morning, I'm Natalie Hadley with your KQNK News. Brought to you by Firebolt Ag, LLC, serving all of your chemical and fertilizer needs. A Hayes man was arrested on July 29th on several charges related to child pornography through social media. According to court records, the suspect, 21-year-old Josiah Curtis Grizzle of Hayes, was arrested on charges including alleged aggravated internet trading in child pornography, sexual exploitation of a child, possession of media involving a child younger than 18 years old, and sexual extortion. According to the court records, the alleged victim was born in 2007 and would be 16 or 17 years old. The child pornography counts allegedly occurred in February and March on Snapchat and Facebook, or Meta, and the sexual extortion offenses allegedly occurred on July 29th. Grizzle's bond has been set at $250,000. In 2021, Grizzle was arrested for aggravated endangerment of a child younger than 18 years old, interference with law enforcement for fleeing or attempting to elude through reckless driving, possession of THC, and possession of drug paraphernalia. He pled no contest to charges of aggravated endangerment of a child and interference with law enforcement, and he pled guilty to a second count of aggravated endangerment of a child and interference with law enforcement. The charges for the possession of THC and possession of drug paraphernalia were dismissed. Grizzle was placed in community corrections in January 2022 and released a year later. The Hayes Police Department has not released a statement, and they remind the public that all parties are innocent until proven guilty. U.S. Department of Agriculture Kansas Rural Development Director Christy Davis announced that the USDA will help farmers and small businesses expand access to clean energy and lower energy bills through the Rural Energy for America, or REAP, program. Davis said rural development is investing $1,789,170 in grants that will support 15 clean energy projects across Kansas. And they're working hard supporting Kansas' small businesses and farmers as they create jobs for their communities. REAP enables agriculture producers and rural small business owners to expand their use of wind, solar, geothermal, and small hydropower energy and make energy efficiency improvements. These innovations help them increase their income, grow their businesses, and address climate change while lowering energy costs for American families. And this announcement is part of a larger national announcement that includes projects in 38 other states and Guam. The USDA continues to accept REAP applications and has set aside a portion of the program funds to support underused renewable energy technologies. For additional information, you can contact a local energy coordinator. The USDA Rural Development provides loans and grants to help expand economic opportunities, create jobs, and improve the quality of life for millions of Americans in rural areas. And to learn more, you can visit USDA.gov. U.S. Senator Jerry Moran of Kansas, the ranking member of the Senate Veterans Affairs Committee, joined Senator Marco Rubio of Florida in introducing legislation to require the Department of Veterans Affairs to consider continuity of health care when deciding whether seeing a provider in their community is in a veteran's best medical interest. Under current law, there are several criteria that the Veterans Affairs is required to take into account when determining whether it is in the veteran's best medical interest to seek care outside of a VA medical facility. So the Ensuring Continuity in Veterans Health Act would add continuity of care to that criteria, which would help veterans who have been engaged in care in their community be able to continue receiving treatment from their community care provider. Senator Moran said he's hearing from more and more veterans in Kansas and across the country who are finding it harder to receive the care they're entitled to from Veterans Affairs and who are being cut off from their community providers. He said this legislation would help veterans maintain care with the doctors and nurses they have come to trust by requiring Veterans Affairs to take continuity of care into account when evaluating veterans for community care referrals. The legislation was also co-sponsored by eight other senators. In Nebraska news, Lincoln police reported that just before 7 p.m. on Tuesday, a bicyclist made an illegal crossing at 27th and Randolph Streets. Officers then tried to stop the bicyclist. However, police said the man, identified as 41-year-old Travis Hollowhorn, rode away, and they said he resisted arrest even as officers tried to shock him with a taser. The first two tries with the taser were unsuccessful, but Hollowhorn was hit the third time. He was arrested on suspicion of resisting arrest. Hollowhorn had an outstanding warrant for criminal trespass, criminal mischief, obstructing a peace officer, and failure to appear. 53-year-old Ramon Lopez Larios was sentenced on Tuesday for possession with intent to distribute 500 grams or more of methamphetamine and 100 grams or more of fentanyl, as well as being an illegal alien in possession of a firearm after getting caught with drug-filled statues in Nebraska. According to authorities, on August 18, 2022, Nebraska state troopers pulled over a vehicle on Interstate 80 near Cozad. A dog smelled drugs, so authorities searched the vehicle, and inside they found two hollow foam statues, and inside those statues they discovered 59 pounds of methamphetamine and 9 pounds of fentanyl, along with a gun. And Lopez Larios had $2,900 in his pocket. After prison, Lopez Larios will serve 5 years on supervised release, and he will also forfeit the $2,900 to the federal government. According to the Nebraska Department of Transportation, weather permitting, a milling and chip seal project will begin on or about August 15th on N61. Chip seal is an application of an asphalt binder to a roadway surface followed by an aggregate, and cold milling is a process of removing deteriorated asphalt in preparation of placing a chip seal to improve the roadway surface and drivability. State maintenance forces will be performing the milling and chip seal project from reference post 18.4 to reference post 26.9, starting 1.2 miles south of Enders Dam, working south 8.5 miles. The anticipated completion is 10 days, and the traffic will be maintained with the pilot car and flaggers. Motorists are reminded to drive cautiously in and near work zones, to buckle up, and to put their phones down. I'll be back with more in just a moment.
Firebolt Ag is a full-service fertilizer and chemical retailer. They customize products for individual farmers' needs, with the primary focus being customer profitability. Let Josh and Jack help you get the most out of your farm ground. They also provide in-house marketing with Ron Wall of Flatwater Solutions. Visit Ron in Phillipsburg or call Josh at 785-854-8484 or Jack at 308-840-2819. Firebolt Ag, your leader in agriculture.
On Monday, the Kansas Association of Broadcasters announced the individual station awards for the year 2024, and Deerkin Communications Incorporated achieved remarkable recognition by winning 3 first-place awards. Notably, their website, sunflowerstateradio.com, was honored as the best website in the small market radio category. KD Country 94 also made a significant impact by securing 2 first-place awards. Dusty Dines received accolades for his outstanding work in the complete sportcast category, specifically for a sports report detailing the Kansas City Chiefs Super Bowl victory. And furthermore, KD Country 94 excelled in the sports play-by-play category with its broadcast of the Kansas 8-man division All-Star Game, showcasing the talents of Wade Gerstner, Todd Clover, and Dusty Dines. The award ceremony, where station representatives will be recognized for their achievements, is set to occur in October during the Kansas Association of Broadcasters Awards Dinner in Wichita. This event will highlight the accomplishments and contributions of local broadcasters throughout the state. Just after 4 p.m. on Wednesday in Norton County, the Kansas Highway Patrol reported that a 2013 BMW motorcycle driven by 80-year-old Alan E. Gantert of Freeville, New York, was eastbound on U.S. 36, 1.5 miles west of U.S. 283. The motorcycle struck the passenger side tires of a 1999 Mack Semi driven by 78-year-old Robert W. Bowman of Norton, who was making a left turn from U.S. 36 onto Norton County Road W1. EMS transported Gantert to Kearney Regional Hospital, where he died, and Bowman was not injured. Gantert was not wearing a helmet, according to the Kansas Highway Patrol. The Kansas Department of Agriculture has funds available for certified organic operators through the National Organic Certification Cost Share Program, or NOCCSP, where farms, ranches, and businesses that produce, process, or package certified organic agricultural products may be reimbursed for eligible expenses. The purpose of the NOCCSP is to defray the costs of receiving and maintaining organic certification under the National Organic Program. The U.S. Department of Agriculture Farm Service Agency awards the NOCCSP funds to eligible state agencies who work directly with organic operators to reimburse organic certification costs. The Kansas Department of Agriculture can reimburse costs incurred from October 1, 2023 through September 30, 2024, and applications are being accepted now through October 31, 2024, or until all the funds are expended, whichever comes first. The applications may be submitted either by mail or email. It's the mission of the Kansas Department of Agriculture to support all facets of agriculture, including lending support to those who wish to market and sell their products as certified organic. For more information, you can go to the Kansas Department of Agriculture website at agriculture.ks.gov/OCCSP, or you can contact the Kansas Department of Agriculture Grants Coordinator Brittany Grother at 785-564-6797. I'm Natalie Hadley. Your KQNK News was brought to you by Firebolt Ag, LLC, farmers helping farmers to succeed. You can contact Firebolt Ag today to get the most out of your farmland. Your KQNK weather forecast is being brought to you by Hinkle Termite and Pest Control, your Norton experts for all of your pest control needs. Your forecast for today, there's a chance of showers and thunderstorms before 4 p.m., then a slight chance of showers, and it should be mostly cloudy with a steady temperature around 67. We should have a north wind of 10 to 15 miles per hour, and the chance of precipitation is 40%. For tonight, there's a 30% chance of showers and thunderstorms after 1 a.m. Otherwise, it's going to be mostly cloudy with a low around 55 and a north wind of 5 to 10 miles per hour. On Friday, there's a 40% chance of showers and thunderstorms, mainly before 1 p.m., and patchy fog between 1 p.m. and 2 p.m. Otherwise, it'll be mostly cloudy with a high near 69 and an east wind around 5 miles per hour. And on Friday night, there's a 30% chance of showers and thunderstorms after 1 a.m. It should be cloudy with a low around 55. I'll be back with the rest of your forecast in just a moment.
When you've got bugs, we know what a nuisance that can be.
Lock 'em out. from Hinkle Termite and Pest Control. Lock 'em Out is our very effective residential insect prevention program. We'll come to your place and treat your foundation plus all insect entryways. And while we're there, receive a free termite inspection. Call Mr. Rich Wenzel, our certified technician in Norton, at 785-202-0167. That's 202-0167.
Continuing with your weather forecast, on Saturday, there's a chance of showers before 10 a.m., and then a chance of showers and thunderstorms between 10 a.m. and 1 p.m. On Saturday, it should be mostly cloudy with a high near 72, and the chance of precipitation is 40%. On Sunday, there's a 30% chance of showers before 1 p.m. Otherwise, it'll be partly sunny with a high near 78. On Monday, there's a 20% chance of showers and thunderstorms before 1 p.m. Should be partly sunny with a high near 84. On Tuesday, there's a 20% chance of showers and thunderstorms. Should be partly sunny with a high near 87. And on Wednesday, it should be mostly sunny with a high near 90. Currently, with overcast skies, it is 66 degrees. The humidity is 88%. The wind speed is northeast at 17 miles per hour. The barometric pressure is 30.17. And the dew point is 63 degrees. Your weather was brought to you by Hinkle Termite and Pest Control right here in Norton. You can call Hinkle Termite and Pest Control at 785-202-0167 for all of your pest control needs. It is 8:20 and it's time for Kansas Sports, brought to you by United Northwest Federal Credit Union, where everything they do for you.
Save more, earn more with the Easy Saver account at the United Northwest Federal Credit Union. Enrollment in this program automatically rounds up the amount of all debit card and share draft purchases made from your checking account to the next whole dollar and deposits into the Easy Saver savings account. Not only will this account help you save, but it also earns 2.01% APY monthly. Special terms and conditions apply. Come in today and open your Easy Saver account at the United Northwest Federal Credit Union, where everything we do for you. NCUA insured.
KIN Sports, I'm Spencer Dupuy. Dylan Edwards transferred to Kansas State from Colorado earlier this year, and with DJ Giddens already on the top of the depth chart for the Wildcats, starting quarterback Avery Johnson says they have found creative ways to use Edwards on offense.
Just explosive with the ball in his hand, so just trying our best to get it to him in space and let him do his thing, whether that's out of the backfield and any type of motion, even splitting him out and letting him play some receiver, just kind of using him in any way we can so that we can keep defenses on their toes.
The offense also used the spring practice period to evolve a lot more than they were at the end of last season.
I'd say definitely the spring was where we kind of had to get those kinks out, adding in some new concepts, some new schemes, figuring some stuff out. But now it's just we know what we're supposed to do. We know our techniques. We know what the coaches want from us, so it's just going out there and executing it.
The Wildcats open up the season August 31st at home against UT Martin. Kansas Information Network Sports, I'm Spencer Dupuy.
In the world of modern agriculture, one name stands out, Precision Planting. With a mission to empower farmers, Precision Planting has been at the forefront of innovation, transforming the way crops are planted. From their intuitive planter, seeder, and harvest monitoring tools to groundbreaking sprayer and fertilizer application technology, Precision Planting's smart solutions bring a new level of precision and efficiency to every pass you make in the field. But it's not just about technology. It's about helping farmers make practical and effective decisions when it comes to their operations. Imagine tapping into yields that could only be dreamt of and making them a reality using equipment you already own. Precision Planting is more than a technology company. It's your partner on your journey to higher yields and pursuing excellence. They've spent over 30 years bringing confidence to farms like yours. Join the ranks of farmers who trust Precision Planting to revolutionize their operation. To get started with your local premier dealer, visit precisionplanting.com today.
It's true, many of us spend more time thinking about what's for dinner than preparing for retirement. But if you think your retirement needs deserve more attention, I agree, and I'd like to help. I'm Edward Jones Financial Advisor Philip Eisenhagen. Together we can give your long-term retirement strategy the attention it deserves. Stop by our office at 418 East Holm here in Norton or call 877-3373. Edward Jones, Making Sense of Investing, member SIPC.